How are you?
I'm absolutely fine.
Are you comfortable?
Yes.
Shall we begin the interview?
By all means.
Okay, let me first introduce myself. My name is Ashwini and I'll be taking your IELTS interview today. I'll begin with the introductory part where I'll ask some questions related to your life. Firstly, tell me your full name.
My name is Deepak Sharma.
How may I call you?
You can call me with my first name Deepak.
Can I see your ID?
Yes, here it is.
Deepak, do you study or you work?
I'm working in automobile industry as a sales executive and it's been almost 3 years now.
Deepak, now I'll ask some questions about music. Do you like listening to music?
Yes, I'm fond of listening to music and it is my most common leisure time activity. In fact, I have a huge collection of my favorite Hindi, English and Punjabi songs in my mobile phone.
What kind of music do you listen to and why?
Well, I'm not much aware about the type of music. I mostly listen to Punjabi rock, hip-hop and rap songs, which are quite popular nowadays. I also like soulful Bollywood songs sung by Arijit Singh and Rahat Fateh Ali Khan.
Has the music that you listen to changed since you were young?
Yes. At that time, I would only enjoy the dance numbers regardless of the lyrics. But now, I pay attention to the lyrics as well as the quality of singing. I also like to listen instrumental music while reading a self-help book or a novel as it helps me in concentrating.
Do you think older and younger generation prefer different type of music?
Obviously. Their taste differs in many aspects. Young people prefer more to listen loud and noisy party songs, while old people might like soft and soothing music like ghazals and classical.
Are there any musical concerts held in area where you live?
I hail from a small town. That's why any big scale musical concerts are not very common in my city. Sometimes small musical events are organized on occasions like Christmas and New Year, where local artists entertain people by singing trending and famous tracks.
Do you play any musical instrument?
No, I do not play any musical instrument, although I have a keen desire to learn guitar or violin, but for some reason I am not able to keep it on priority. That's why it is more like a wish which is not coming true.
Okay, this is the end of part 1. Let's move on to part 2, which is a cue card. You will be given a topic. You can make notes for 1 minute, then you have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. Your topic is, tell about an exhibition you attended recently, what it was about, when and where you attended, what you liked about it. Here's the pencil and paper for notes.
I do not often visit fairs and exhibitions, even in my own city. But last year, my friends forcefully took me to the International Trade Fair in the month of November. This event is held between 14 to 27th November every year at Pragati Maidan in New Delhi. It is a common platform for the national and international manufacturers, traders and service providers. The fair displays a wide range of products and services related to almost all the industries such as textile, electronic appliance, telecommunication, food and beverage, etc. It also shows the achievements and progress chart of all the Indian states. Initially, I was reluctant to go because I thought that it was only for business people, but I was wrong. It was quite informative for me as well. Because of its huge size, it was not possible to see everything in a day. That's why I was selected few spots from a map which was available at the entry point. We directly went to the Haryana Bhavan and it was amazing to know about the facts of Haryana which I did not know. Things like handicrafts, food products, agriculture implements and eco-friendly automobiles were on display. I felt good to see that Haryana is manufacturing all this. I bought some souvenirs for my close ones. Then we went to a hall which was totally dedicated to books because I love reading books. I had never seen so many local and foreigner publishers at the same place for the promotion of their books. I bought a couple of novels and motivational books. We had to come back home, that's why we could not visit many other exciting parts of the fair. I thanked my friends for taking me to that place, which I really liked for its grand scale and large coverage of industries and areas. It is a must-visit event for everyone, I think. I will never miss this in following years.
Now I'll ask some follow-up questions. Why do you think exhibitions are organized?
Well, the main motive behind such events is the promotion of certain products or services of a company and artwork of an individual or a group. For example, publishing houses might use exhibitions to showcase their latest arrivals, and a painter could display his paintings to maximize its reach among the masses.
When such exhibitions are usually organized?
I have noticed that short-term fairs and exhibitions are mostly organized during festivals and public holidays, when people tend to go out of their homes for shopping or entertainment purpose, although some museums or exhibition halls are operational throughout the year.
What are the certain benefits of exhibitions for visitors?
It depends on the nature of exhibition. For example, if there is any book fair, then only book lovers will find it interesting and useful. If it is related to science, then science background students will admire it more. Sometimes things of common interest are displayed, such as home appliances, handicrafts, etc. In such case, all have a chance to know about new products and buy according to their needs.
Do people show interest in such exhibitions in your country?
I think yes. I live in a highly populated country where consumer base is very large. If any exhibition is properly advertised, then people see it as an opportunity to hang out with family members and friends. Most people like window shopping, so they do not mind visiting there for once.
Should school students be taken to exhibitions and art galleries?
Yes, it is a good idea to arrange a trip for school students to any display of cultural, historical, or scientific significance. Usually, young children are very curious, and such exhibitions can be both educational and entertaining for them.
Okay, Deepak, this is the end of your speaking test.
Thank you.